What is the best way to attach a rubber shock cord to a Kevlar shock cord in your rocket? That's what I'm going to cover in this video.
Welcome to Advanced Construction Videos, where we show you how to tackle rocketry building techniques and more. On our website, we sell kits, motors, building supplies, and electronics. So come and learn, shop, build, and fly when you visit us at apogeerockets.com.
Hi, I'm Tim Van Milligan from Apogee Components. I'd like to show you how to properly attach an elastic shock cord to a Kevlar shock cord inside your rocket. Now, if you do it wrong, you kind of defeat the purpose of using a Kevlar shock cord and a rubber shock cord together. And I'll kind of explain that to you. So basically, I've built kind of a clear rocket right here to kind of show you how things are inside of this. We have a Kevlar shock cord, and it's attached to the motor mount down here at the bottom. When you do this, when you attach the shock cords together, it's important to do it before you assemble your rocket. So my rocket comes apart so that I can, you know, take everything apart and show you how to do it properly. Now, ideally, and this is where it's, you know, the important part is that the attachment point of the rubber shock cord to the Kevlar shock cord should be inside of the tube so that the Kevlar doesn't come out of the tube, because what can happen with Kevlar is it can zipper the tube because it is so strong and so skinny that it puts a lot of stress on one little corner and it will cut into the tube. And to prevent that, we need to keep the Kevlar on the inside. If you're not going to do that, you might as well just use a long piece of Kevlar. In most of the Apogee kits that we sell, it is a long piece of Kevlar. But you need to have the Kevlar extremely long so that it doesn't have a chance to zipper the tube. Now, a lot of people like to use a rubber shock cord to prevent zippering and to prevent nose cone snapback. Not nose cone snapback, but to prevent damage to the nose cone loop on the back by using a rubber shock cord, because it kind of stretches and takes up some of the force. On the Apogee kits, we use really strong shock cord attachment points, so that's really not a concern. So this would only be for nose cones and kits from other manufacturers. So when you do this, what I have here is I've already attached the shock cord to the engine mount. And this is where the engine mount is going to be positioned, because as you can see, I have through the wall tabs that have to go through the middle of the centering rings. So that's where that's positioned. And so we need to first measure where we're going to put the knot and where we're going to attach. So I'm going to pull the whole thing out, and I'm just going to lay it next to the tube in the right location. So here's my slot. So here's my rings. So that's where that's going to go. And then I'm just going to slide the whole thing over so you can see it. And so we need the tip of the shock cord at least to be here or inside the tube. So I'm going to take a marker, and I'm going to mark the maximum location where that can be. And from here, I'm going to hold that at the apex, and I can tie my first knot. And this one is just a simple overhand knot. So you're just going to take the shock cord and just do a loop, bring it up through the hole. Remember to hold on to that point right there and then pull tight. Now it doesn't really matter how long this loop is. Mine is actually pretty long. But then when you're done, make sure you double check the length. Make sure everything is right. So again, I got my my slot here and my rings there. And I just want to make sure that this is inside of the tube, and that's correct. It is. So at that point, I can cut off this excess length of shock cord, because this is just excess. So I'm going to cut that. And next, you can either put the rubber shock cord on now or you can do it later. I recommend doing it now because it's going to be so close to the front of the tube. You can get inside and attach it, but I recommend attaching it now. So you can just, you know, tie it on here. I use a slip knot as my favorite, but you might have another favorite. So mine is I just make a loop, bring it up through, take this other end, go around there, and then this goes back through the loop, and then you pull everything nice and tight, just like that, once you get everything tight. But I want to undo this and show you how you can do it once it's in the tube. So again, I'm going to put this inside here. Got to get it started. Come on. There we go. And I'm just going to put a fin in here just to make sure that it doesn't slide on me. It's a very tight slot. Let's try a different one. Maybe it's a fat fin. Okay, so now that's not going to move. And I can reach in and grab that loop. And again, so here it's on the inside. I'm going to take this shock cord, and I need to bring it through. And if you're having a hard time, what you can do is use, you know, a little forceps. Stick it through the loop, and then grab the cord, there we go, and then just bring it out. Okay, and again, same technique, make a loop here with this one, and then take this other end. I want to take that free end, go around the shock cord, and then back through the hole that this came out of, just like that, and then pull it tight. Now this is a slip knot, so I can slide it down into the tube, as you can see right there, and then just pull everything really tight. And at this point, you know, now that this rubber shock cord is on the edge, and it's not going to dig into the cord because it can stretch. Not going to dig into the tube because it can stretch. So at that point, you know, you can glue everything up, you know, and attach the other end to the loop on the base of the nose cone, put your parachute also up there at the top, and then basically your rocket's done. So that is, you know, the trick on attaching a elastic or rubber shock cord to a Kevlar shock cord. And like I said, if you're using an Apogee kit, we make ours all Kevlar, but we make them really long so that we don't have that chance of zippering the tube. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And may the winds be light, may the skies be blue, and may all your rockets fly straight and true.